Actually, we are reaching steps that nobody else have done before.
Now we are in a totally new phase. Now it's dominated by data processing scientists.
The Gaia data will shine new light in practically every corner of astronomy, and astronomy is a wide field.
So these are observations that are going to be the standard in astronomy for the next 50 years, and they'll be valid in 100 years' time.
All stars we see at night belong to our Milky Way. It is a galaxy consisting of about 200 billion stars, star clusters and clouds of gas and dust from which new stars and planets are born. The rotating disk-like structure measures about 100,000 light-years in diameter and is a typical example for millions of other galaxies. To investigate its structure dynamics and history, we need to know the three-dimensional positions and motions of as many stars as possible very precisely, including their distances from the Earth. The key instrument for this challenge is the Gaia mission for the high-precision mapping of more than 1 billion stars over a period of 5 years, leading to an unprecedented huge catalog of a representative subset of the galactic stellar population. And now, an important milestone has been reached. The first Gaia catalogue is published.
Already this first Gaia catalogue will revolutionize qualitatively and quantitatively our understanding of the stars in our Milky Way. Of particular importance in this respect is the measurement of 2 million stellar distances.
Gaia lifted off in December 2013 from the launch site of the European Space Agency in French Guiana in South America. The satellite's destination was a region around the Lagrange point L2 at a distance of 1.5 million kilometers from the Earth. At L2, a body follows Earth's orbit around the Sun almost free of other forces, due to the balance between the gravity of the Sun and the Earth at this region. Undisturbed by Earth and Moon, and equipped with a huge sun shield, Gaia is able to observe any part of the sky while following the Earth on its orbit. Gaia gathers data through two identical reflecting telescopes which simultaneously observe two regions of the sky 107 degrees apart. As Gaia rotates once every 6 hours, strips of the sky are scanned in order to precisely measure the positions of celestial objects. The primary mirror of each telescope measures 145 by 50 centimeters and focuses the light of the stars onto more than 100 CCD detectors with a total of almost 1 billion pixels.
Yeah, so Gaia has three instruments on board. One instrument dedicated to astrometry, so collecting distances and motions of stars. One instrument dedicated to measuring colors and also the properties of stars, such as their age and their chemical composition. And we have one instrument which is collecting high-resolution spectra, and these are dedicated to measuring the radial velocity of the stars and also actually to look at their atmospheric properties.
But the main goal is the measurement of accurate stellar parallaxes to determine the three-dimensional positions and motions of stars very precisely, including their distances from the Earth. Parallaxes are familiar to each of us. We are able to estimate distances to nearby objects because each of our eyes sees an object from a slightly different perspective. We also notice such a perspective shift depending on the distance to an object when we move, for example in a train, through the countryside. Thus, as the Earth moves around the Sun, we should observe such a parallax effect also for stars. But due to the large distances of even the nearest stars, it took until 1838 before Friedrich Wilhelm Bessel finally announced the first good stellar parallax and distance measurement of a star. Parallaxes are extremely small and difficult to measure, currently with a limit for ground-based telescopes at a few hundred light-years. Going beyond this requires observing from space. A major step forward was the launch of the astrometric satellite Hipparcos in 1989, which measured accurate parallaxes of over 100,000 stars. Gaia now extend this much further by observing a billion stars with even higher precision and out to much larger distances.
To get to the precision that we want, we need in a way to determine the relative locations of the Gaia mirrors, 1.5 meters big, and the CCD chips on which the light is recorded, to the order of a few atom diameters.
And this has to be continuously under control over the 5 years of observations to achieve for Gaia's final catalog astrometric measurements which can reach accuracies up to about 20 microarcseconds. This is roughly equivalent to measuring the motion across a coin at the distance of the Moon, as seen from Earth. And now the first Gaia measurements became public on September 14, 2016.
The Gaia measurements were collected between July 25, 2014 and September 16, 2015. Taking into account that there are some gaps, we have 11 months of data in total. The catalog stars had between 5 and 25 transits through Gaia's focal plane.
And already for this first data set, still far away in precision from the final catalog, some numbers are very impressive.
55 million stars passed Gaia's focal plane every day, leading to about 500 million astrometric measurements per day. Therefore, the first Gaia catalog with more than 1 billion stars down to magnitude 21 was built from about 200 billion astrometric observations.
However, some effort is needed to prepare that Gaia data for the scientific community. Responsible for that is the Gaia Data Processing and Analysis Consortium, DPAC, in collaboration with ESA.
The raw form of the data cannot be interpreted directly by astronomers or by anyone for that matter, and they need to be turned into the eventual science products, the distances to the stars, their properties, etc. And this is the work that DPAC does. DPAC takes the raw information from Gaia, processes that through a complicated big software system involving lots of data processing centers and lots of people, and turns that eventually into the results that scientists then can actually interpret and use, and also the general public, of course.
For the first catalog, some Gaia data had to be combined with former Hipparchos data.
The TIGAS catalog from our TICO Gaia astrometric solution, where we have combined the TICO 2 catalog measured 24 years ago by the Hipparchos satellite with the Gaia data just recently taken, this catalog contains 2 million stars for which we could determine the angular positions, the parallaxes and the proper motions per year with a typical precision of 0.3 milliarcseconds and an additional systematic error of the same order. For the other 1 billion stars in the first catalog, we have only positional measurements with a typical precision of 0.6 milliarcseconds. However, for a few stars, the uncertainties reach more than 20 milliarcseconds, which is still good compared to many older star catalogs.
No question, already the first Gaia catalog is a milestone. But it's just the beginning, because
The uncertainty of the star positions and motions and distances in this first release will be about of the order of 10 times as big as in the final catalog.
In addition to the astrometric data, later Gaia catalogs will also contain many of the physical properties of the stars derived from other onboard instruments.
We have the photometer on board and we have the spectrometer on board. So what one can really expect is the photometric part, so that we can actually tell what the stars look like. And the spectroscopy part is really to get the radial velocities out. So those are something which are eagerly waited. But we are then, when we have more data, we are doing further processing in order to be able to provide the community astrophysical parameters of stars, more variability information. So the whole spectrum will come in the course of years.
Galaxies like our Milky Way undergo dramatic dynamic changes due, for example, to gravitational interactions or even merging with other, mostly smaller galaxies. Therefore, one important goal of the Gaia mission is the study of the evolution of our galaxy over timescales of billions of years. To achieve this goal, all the Gaia data have to be combined.
The goal of Gaia is the archaeology of the galaxy, how the galaxy has evolved, how they have formed. So if we know how the stars move, but we do not know which are the age of the stars, or which is the chemical composition of those stars, we are missing a lot. So the full picture of how the galaxy has evolved can come only joining together all the information, the kinematics, the dynamics of the object, but also the properties, the physical properties of the objects, ages and chemical compositions, basically.
The huge amount of data will also reveal other objects far beyond the Milky Way, such as other galaxies and quasars. Gaia will also detect many planets around other stars. Finally, Gaia will discover thousands of comets and asteroids in our solar system. Gaia will significantly expand our knowledge of the universe.